Essex, India, Sheffield. And for the first time, our cameras will be at the very heart of the blast to record the moment known as blowdown.
We don't mind if we press the button and block them come down. If we hurt anybody, it's the end of the line.
Most buildings will come down if you put explosives in them, but whether it comes down where you want it to come down, causing no damage, no injury, that's a buzz for me, as probably as much as the building coming down.
I've never felt like that sort of excited before, is what I do when I'm doing this. Definitely better than sex. Better than any sex I've ever had.
Three towers on Norfolk Park Estate, Sheffield, and the controlled demolition group has moved in. It will be the biggest blast in Britain this year. This is known in the trade as a soft strip. The team is removing anything that's not concrete.
I went in December 1967. I'd been moved from slum clearance. I'd been able to choose my own flat. It was on the fourth floor. It overlooked Norfolk Park, and it was really lovely.
78-year-old Dora Crooks lived in this flat for 31 years. Once the soft stripping is done, it's time for the peckers, the machines that hammer through concrete. Non-supporting walls are being removed from the floors, which will contain explosives. This will help the towers collapse more easily. Holes are being drilled to house the explosives.
And how many floors are you putting explosives in?
Four floors we're doing with explosives.
Which floors?
We're doing ground, fourth, eighth and 12th.
And why are you only putting them on some floors?
I'm sorry?
Why are you only putting it on some floors?
We're trying to use the minimum amount of explosives required to get the buildings down. And by removing it on fourth, removing the columns and walls on four floors, that's enough to get these buildings to topple over.
The preparation work will last 5 months.
You're terrible, you vandals.
For a demolition man, the only thing that counts is getting a building down safely.
I don't think there is any higher priority than individual safety, whether it's employee or the general public. It's top of the list. No job is worth people being killed or injured.
1990 and controlled demolition bring down a power station in Plymouth.
Everything came down perfectly and that was that. No reports of any damage. And just as we were getting ready to leave the site, we got a report that a member of the public had been hit by a piece of mud. And we assumed a piece of mud, it was like a splash out of a puddle or something.
In fact, following 3 days of heavy rain, the impact of the chimney had launched a 7-pound piece of mud over the 70-foot quarry wall. It flew 300 feet and hit a spectator in the back.
The upshot of it all was that he died. Very regrettable situation. But at the time, unavoidable. It was something that I don't think could have reasonably been foreseen.
The official inquiry exonerated controlled demolition, though their insurers later paid compensation to the family. Since then, Charles Moran has helped introduce rules increasing the size of exclusion zones.
There's two ways you can deal with it. You can either pack the job in and walk away from it, or you can do something about the job and make sure it doesn't happen again. I like to think that we've contributed something towards the latter.
There have been more than 500 explosive demolitions in Britain in the last 10 years. Two people have died. This is the conventional way to demolish a building. They're taking this tower block down floor by floor. It used to be 17 stories. Yeah! This work is being done by conventional demolition man John Hall, but his next job is an explosive demolition, and he's nervous.
I've always been apprehensive. I've seen too many structures hang up in the past, and it's a terrible feeling when someone pushes the button and the explosion goes off and the structure doesn't come down. I've no worries whatsoever about this, but having seen four major hang-ups in my lifetime and had to be one of the guys going back and helping to recharge it, you can't help to, you know, sometimes have you, until that thing's on the floor, I won't be happy.
For a demolition man, this is one of your worst nightmares. The hang-up.
For about 3 or 4 minutes, you stand there and look at it and think, well, come on, down. It was quite clear at the time that the buildings weren't going anywhere.
These tower blocks were being held up by what the plans showed as non-supporting walls. A hydraulic ram was called in to give the buildings a nudge.
It was just a matter of just pushing one corner of the building and the whole thing collapsed as planned, really, albeit a little bit late.
John Hall is haunted by a series of hang-ups.
And it stayed there, just shook. So we threw all the sandwiches away, we took the champagne home with us, and it was an absolute disaster. Your heart sinks into your stomach. So you can imagine, as a young man, and having seen all these horror stories, there's no reason why I had any desire to become an explosives engineer.
The gas holder eventually came down, but after four hang-ups, John had seen enough of explosive demolition, until now. This is the test that faces John. In 48 hours, these two sugar silos in Essex will be blasted. At least, that's the plan. The team are checking the site.
They'll break and then they'll start to go.
And then they'll start squatting
down on themselves, but at the same time coming out. They're like a jar, aren't they?
Yeah.
There's nothing inside, so they'll just flatten themselves.
And also, you're going to get some rumble.
Ooh, like a clap of thunder. Then nothing will happen. People go, it's all gone wrong. And all of a sudden, you'll hear a crack, and then it will start going.
I mean, the last thing Philip's going to do is undercharge them. You cannot, there's no way you want those bloody things to hang up.
Norfolk Park, Sheffield. 7 weeks before blowdown, and they're having a test blast to gauge how much explosive is needed. They're also testing whether this protective wrapping will contain the blast.
He's taken all the concrete out we wanted it to. It's not flown a significant distance. The protection's contained all the concrete inside. And that's ideal for us. That's exactly what we're looking for.
For nearby residents, it's just another noisy day in Norfolk Park.
Problems we've had while they've been demolition. There's been noise, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Which hasn't really affected me because I'm not one for staying in bed. I'm always up early in the morning. But there has been an occasion when I would have liked to lie in. But unfortunately, due to this, Monday to Friday, it's been impossible. We've had problems with people. Looking for scrap. But each time we've been on phone or if we've been disturbed, somebody's dealt with it straight away. There's always been somebody on site, haven't there?
Very good security.
Very, very good security man. And explosives man's not too bad, actually. he can light my fuse any day.
Dawn, Sunday morning, Essex. In just 6 hours, this skyline will change forever. The sugar silos will be blasted at midday. Inside, the explosives engineer is checking that the detonation cord linking the 700 sticks of explosives is still in place. And John Hall is anxious.
If that one fails, then that hits it a second time, right. You see, on a delay. There's a delay further on there.
There's one important design criteria.
Yeah.
Don't fuck with it. Make sure there's enough to bring it down.
Yeah.
Our cameras are in position to record the blast.
Don't The worst time is probably a few seconds before someone presses that button. When that siren goes, when you know you're on the countdown, then I can't help being nervous.
What? Fire. Fire.
For one moment, it looks like the silos aren't going anywhere. But this hover is actually quite normal, though not good news if you're a nervous demolition man.
If it had been over in 2 seconds, that would have been it. It would have been over and done with on the news tonight. But this way, we've got about 15 minutes coverage. Behind it blowing.
What I said to you earlier on, you never know.
Be behind it pushing.
Until it's down on the deck, you can't actually then.
Yeah.
...5,000 miles from Essex, and it's the monsoon season in Ramagundam, central India. In 3 days' time, the town's power station will be the site of India's biggest ever explosive demolition. Two cooling towers, 200 feet high, and a boiler house are due to be demolished, and it's causing some interest among the locals.
Why are you here? Okay? Not here. Away? Come on. Okay, helmet. No. Okay, over there.
Dick
then.
Green of the controlled demolition group has been called in to do the job, and he's a long way from home. One of his main challenges is health and safety, and they do things differently here.
This is a scaffold that we use to charge up, whereas in UK we'd have mobile towers or something. There was no chance over here, all they had was wood and rope. So it's going back a bit in time, but they built it up. This, here, around this way. Okay, no problem. Okay, wait, now. This, here. This corner? No. Okay. To me? No, wait. This here. No. We bring here. Watch me. This here. Okay? Here. Just make sure you put the legs up enough so it's firm.
No,
okay?
Okay.
Dick is working with two colleagues from the UK, Wayne Winfendale and David Palmer.
How long have you been over here now?
Yeah, we're on for 2 weeks, went on for a week, and then we've been back a week now. Mr. Green, he's been over 6 weeks. Nightmare.
They're using 1,000 sticks of explosives and 2.5 miles of detonating cord. But Dick's worried the heavy rain might affect the connections.
With the monsoon being here, there's been a lot of rain over the last 3 days, and it is a concern about the detonating cord getting damp. So we've taped the ends We've taped the knots, we've cleared the water out of the holes, and we've plugged them, and that's all we can do. But the driving rain is still getting into the concrete.
Back in Sheffield, 19-year-old Holly Bennett is charging the towers with explosives. She used to be part of Controlled Demolition's admin staff.
It was actually at this site, two years ago, came down here. The excitement is unbelievable. And I was absolutely ecstatic, although I'd had nothing to do with it. And then I just said, I spoke to Mick Williams and says, I really want to do this. And because I was 17, and I'm female, I think it was a bit of a, yeah, okay, kind of thing at first. Bit of a laugh for everybody.
The middle one's going first off.
But now she's training to be an explosives engineer, and the only woman doing this work in Britain today.
Yeah.
Sorted. I can't do the drilling, because you do need brute force to do that, and it's something that I just haven't got. For charging the explosives, you don't have to be physically strong for that. But if you didn't have a bit of force behind you, you would run into problems, because you have to be fairly fit to go up and down tower blocks several times a day.
Sit, okay, down.
One day to blow down in Ramagundam, and to everyone's relief, it stopped raining. The explosives have been strategically placed so the towers will fall exactly where Dick wants them to fall.
And the way we do this is by attacking a certain percentage of the legs and the shell. When we set the explosives off, the tower will start tilting slightly in the direction that we've taken the legs away. After a while, the extra weight that's on the legs that are remaining will collapse those legs, and it gives it a twisting, a telescoping motion, which twists it in on itself, so it all falls generally within the circle of its base.
You finish there, fellas? You finish that side?
Yeah, it's done.
Okay, do you want to walk around that way? Just check mine, make sure there's no that you can see that looks wrong, and I'll check yours in a sec.
Okay. You look at mine, I'll look at yours.
You show me mine, and I'll show you yours, yeah. And if you do find out wrong, don't dare say out in front of the cameras.
With 15 hours to go, all the team has to do is wait and hope the rain holds off. After 6 weeks, this is Dick's last night in the local hostel.
Here you can see it's got air conditioning, which is a godsend when it's working, when the power's on, and it's also got a fan, so it's quite cool in the evening. Over here, you don't get loo rolls in toilets, you get stand-up toilets in most places, and it's basically what your left hand's for, and you get a bucket with some water to clean up after, so you never offer greetings or eat food with your left hand in India. So toilet roll, a godsend. We've got quite a good sufficient supply of that. I've got one there. I've also got one by the bed, just in case you get caught short when the deli belly comes upon you. It comes upon you quite quick, so you need to be able to grab it and run. But during the week, I must say, I do wake up at 3 o'clock in the morning thinking, have I done this? Will I do that? This needs doing. I wonder if that's going to turn up. Now it's a stage of, well, whatever we've done is done. There's nothing else we can do, so it's, as they say in here, the Muslims, inshallah, it's God willing it'll all come down.
It's 6 o'clock Sunday morning, and Ramagundam is getting ready for blowdown. 100 lookouts have been brought in to police the exclusion zone. People living nearby are being prepared for evacuation. And on the site, everything is under control. Almost. Dick and the team are checking the explosives and detonation cord are intact.
No problems at the moment. We've got 2 hours to go. Anything can happen in India within 2 hours, so we'll wait and see how it goes. Can we just move you out of the way, please?
How did you sleep last night?
I slept okay last night. I woke up at 2:30, but that's not a problem. I had four and a half hours sleep, and then from there I was just thinking about getting up at 4 o'clock.
Is
अब्बा नहीं कल से बोल रहे
हैं। बाय प्लान बैठे कुछ ना कम ऑन।
Okay, just follow those two leads, fellas, and just check there's no kinks, bends, sharp angles, and it's connected nicely to the rim.
One hour before demolition, and Dick is ready to make the final connections that will bring down the towers with one press of a button. But he needs just one piece of information before blowdown. Is the area clear?
We must confirm it's clear before we fire. If any of you have got a radio that works, can you confirm by just saying yes that the area is clear for us to fire? Over. Just ask them if the area is clear. Mr. Carrero or Mr. Higby, is the area clear?
Firing. Firing point to control point. Is the area clear? Please reply.
At 8 o'clock, Dick finally gets the all clear.
The area clear.
Yeah?
Yes.
Okay, tell them 10 seconds to blow down.
10 seconds to blow down. Firing point to control point. 10 seconds to blow down.
Okay. Firing now!
Firing now! Firing now!
Everybody stay out the area, we haven't finished yet. Tell them everybody stay out the area. Everybody stay out of the area.
20 minutes later, as planned, the boiler house is blasted.
Very proud.
Good job. The camera.
It's D-Day in Sheffield, the biggest blowdown in Britain this year. Dora Crooks is putting on a brave face.
I shan't weep, no, I shan't weep, because I know tears are of no good. But I shall be sorry to see it go, because, as I say, I had so many happy years there. Very, very happy years they were.
Controlled Demolition has got a 50-strong team on duty, and Dick Green, back from India, is about to rally the troops.
We've been here before, haven't we?
Get a sheep out of your eyes, 5 minutes, overalls on, helmets on. And we're buzzing, get the white overalls on. Oh yeah, or a van here, take it out to your position. You send your position, it's outside the zone. Okay, don't leave it here, otherwise it'll get covered in crap.
The 30 lookouts leave the site to take up positions around the edge of the exclusion zone. 150 families have to be evacuated.
Good morning. I'll be out in about half an hour.
Okay then.
Hi.
Yeah, I'm sweet from a taxi.
Right, a taxi's not going to really get here because no cars are allowed in.
Oh, you're lying. Well, I'm not walking. I've just done a night shift from 8 o'clock last night right till 7 this morning.
Because of the exclusion zone, no vehicles can get in, you see. All the roads have been blocked off.
So, right, what am I supposed to do? All right, shut up.
As the zone is evacuated, information is fed to the control point, based in the nearby cemetery. From here, Dick Green is in contact with all the sentries. At midday, he'll be the one to give the order to fire. Holly Bennett is on a special evacuation mission.
Holly, no.
I hate birds. I've got a real thing though when they're flying at you and that, like they do with the pigeons up in the tower block. Didn't enjoy that one bit.
What are you doing next?
Evacuations. I suppose people will be easier than ducks. We don't have to put them in cages, do we?
In the shadow of the towers, Janet Hewitt is preparing to evacuate.
Roast beef was cut last night, so I've just left the juices and I'll warm them through to make my gravy later. I've got my potatoes, my cauliflower and my swede, so I've just got a Yorkshire pudding to make when we get back. Correct. So we can have us dinner What, 1 hour after coming
whenever,
back?
Whenever.
That's if we've got a cooker left. I'll get my shoes on now.
If you make it quick, fellas, you get up there and there's a field just round corner and you get a right good view.
Oh, yeah.
Best view in Sheffield. You run, you have to be quick.
If anybody's forgotten anything tough.
By 10:30, the exclusion zone has been completely evacuated.
Mrs. Crooks!
Alan Farmer, another ex-resident of the flats, is Dora's companion for the blast.
Stand down on bottom.
We've put a camera in Alan's kitchen to record the demolition. These are the windows of Dora and Alan's old flats. And this is the view from Janet's house. We've also positioned cameras on top of a tower, right in the path of where one of the towers will fall. And at the very heart of the blast, inside a floor charged with explosives. Controlled demolition boss Charles Moran is one of the last to leave the site, unreeling the detonation cord which links the explosives to the firing button. It's 5 minutes to blow down. Everything is in place. 5 months of preparation are over. 3,000 holes are charged with 185 pounds of explosives. It's time for blowdown.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Fire now!
Upstairs, we'll sort us off.
These are tears because dust is in my eye, not because I'm crying.
The three towers have been reduced to rubble. There are plans for low-rise flats and houses with gardens to be built in their place.
Good job, mate.
Cheers, mate. Hold on.
Another three bite the dust.
Yeah, they're down. Good job, and it's come down well.
See, look from behind where I was stood, it was brilliant, and we didn't get any dust.
Oh. I got the lot.
Yeah.
We got it.
Ah, you see.
I thought the cabins were going me when it come forward.
When you've been in the business 10 minutes like I have, you know what it's been.
Bet you can't believe it's gone. And what we're going to look at now? Been looking at that all day, every day, and I ain't got out. I think I'd rather have them stood there. It looks strange. Isn't it funny?
As I say, I just went cold. It just...
I don't know. Just as though part of my life had gone. Yeah. Yes. In a second like that, yeah? Yes. Yes. Strange. Very weird. Very weird sensation. Yes. Yeah.
Carol, enjoy that.
Oh. Does anybody want a sandwich? That's all I can say.
I swear my heart stops when we're doing it. But then when you see them come down, you know that everything's all right. So, and they came down absolutely brilliantly.
Is it still better than six?
Well, I'm not quite sure. It's a completely different feeling, so I shouldn't be talking about this. What if somebody's listening? It's completely different, really, but it is just as exciting, if not more so.
But she says it's better than six.
Did she? Nah, she must have been with the wrong fellas.